What's up, guys? It's Eric Haas with EXP Realty in sunny Southern California, bringing it to you live from the west side of Los Angeles. We're here in Mar Vista. Beautiful weather. It's a Friday. I don't know about you, but I'm super stoked about the weekend. It's beautiful weather out. Might hit the beach, but we're about to do a ride along through Mar Vista. We're keeping it real with some pockets here. About to check out Mar Vista Knoll. So hop right next door to me. We're going to take a little ride. Alrighty, guys, we're cruising Centinela Avenue on our way to Mar Vista's pocket of Mar Vista Knoll. And guys, this is the pocket of Mar Vista that happens to be the closest to Santa Monica Airport. Now, that could be a good thing or a bad thing. I've had clients in the past say they wouldn't mind having the airport right in their actual living room and see the airplanes touching down. But others would love to see it go away. And in fact, it is due to go away in 2028. So don't hold your breath. Things have always changed, but that is the plan. 2028 is the year that the Santa Monica Airport will be closing. Now, if you aren't completely familiar with where Mar Vista actually is, well, you can look towards its more infamous neighbors of Venice and Santa Monica, where it actually shares the border with Venice and Santa Monica at Walgrove Avenue. All right, so I got a question for you guys. You may know this, you may not. Take a guess. Drop it in the comments, but I'm curious to know, how many people do you think are in the population of Mar Vista? Now, mind you, this is part of Los Angeles, but just give or take, how many people do you think are in the population of Mar Vista? Alrighty, 3, 2, 1. We've got a total population of actually 55,000 people in the neighborhood of Mar Vista, and Mar Vista is actually made up of 5 square miles. Now guys, before I got into my days of real estate, and right here on Stanwood Drive, I was actually babysat by one of my mom's best friends. And so this kind of got me interested in the neighborhood, I guess, from a young age, because now I find myself not only living here, but also working here. And you can see why. And one of my neighbor friends has actually told me, you know, when people move in here, they never ever leave. And I can understand why, because now I'm local in the hood. And I couldn't agree more. So as I mentioned earlier, this pocket of Mar Vista, Mar Vista Knoll, happens to be the closest to the Santa Monica Airport. Now, we're cruising through here right now in the middle of the day, not hearing an airplane whatsoever. So really, it's just a matter of whether or not it bothers you or not. But up and down this street, we've got crazy sales happening all the time as well, up and north of $3 million. So to be honest, many people aren't really bothered by the whole noise of Santa Monica Airport. Now, the real growth that happened in the population movement in Mar Vista was at the time of World War II. The GIs are coming back with their GI bills, not to mention the people that working at Douglas Airport plant, they were getting off work too. They were looking to start families after the war as well. So this area was actually, again, all bean fields, which Mar Vista mostly was, or orange orchards. But this was all built out to be affordable living for GIs and people working at Douglas Airport plant after the war. All right, so Mar Vista Knoll originally, like I said, was built for GIs. So the original homes were 3-bedroom and 1-bathroom or 2-bedroom, 1-bathroom and averaged a 5,700 square foot lot. Sometimes there were some major huge lots like we're seeing here on Cabrillo Boulevard. Cabrillo Boulevard has some of the largest lots in Mar Vista Knoll, starting around 10,000 square feet and going all the way up north of 18,000 square feet right here on this street. Alrighty guys, now the original homes, when the GIs were coming back from the war and the people were coming back from work from the Douglas Airport plant, they started around $20,000. Now that all depended upon how many bedrooms you had, how big the house was, and obviously how big the lot was as well. Nowadays though, we're looking at 3-bedroom, 2-bathroom minimum. We're not seeing too much of the 2-bedroom, 1-bathroom anymore. They've pretty much been scraped or added on to significantly. And we're also seeing a lot of brand new homes too that are pushing the limits of 4 and 5 bedrooms, taking it to another level from the 1,500 square feet that was kind of the norm to 3,000 to 4,000 square feet plus. And now prices are 4 million plus for brand new and entry is around 1.6. Alrighty, so in Mar Vista Knoll, it's a knoll because it's actually perched up on a hill and there are certain streets that take in some amazing views. This happens to be one of them. We're sitting on Moore, which actually connects to Warren as well. But to the left, you've got some crazy views all the way out to Marina del Rey, all the way out to the ocean of the Pacific. And let me tell you, that's why people are not too, you know, concerned about not having a big lot. They'd rather have that view. Now, as you can see, as we're rolling through the neighborhood, you can see that many of the homes have been remodeled, added onto. You've got second stories as well, like this one right here. So a lot of things are changing in the neighborhood, plus a lot of new construction as well is driving the prices up. And let me tell you guys, you hear those jackhammers, that's another one eating the dust, because there's literally a brand new home being built on almost every single street in Mar Vista right now. And let me tell you, if you're not aware, the market is obscenely hot. Things are flying off the market, and it's nothing like the market that we were seeing just 6 months ago. Aside from the two-story and brand new homes that you can see that are prevalent in the neighborhood and popping up, as I mentioned, on almost every street in the neighborhood, like this one right here, actually, which I sold last year, and they just put in a beautiful new wall after buying that brand new. But let me tell you, values, as I said, are still off the chart. And the only thing that's really changing, aside from the homes going up, is the increase in traffic. And that is only going to be impacted even more so by what occurs in Santa Monica when the airport closes. What's up, brother? Thanks so much. We got another fan. All right, guys, so aside from the traffic, that's really the only nuisance that we really have, occasional airplane here and there. But I have to say, the climate more than makes up for it. As you can see, wonderful, beautiful day out. And it doesn't hurt that the beach is only 4 miles away, which also contributes to this wonderful, nice breeze that we're getting, not only in the springtime, wintertime, but all those summer months, because it can get ultra hot throughout Los Angeles. But right here in Mar Vista, it stays maximum around 80, usually around high 70s. Now, as I mentioned before as well, we've had quite a few celebrities in the neighborhood. And I'm not gonna fail to mention again, some dropping of names. We've had the actor Lloyd Bridges, singer, actress Kesha as well. And then we've also had a few of the skateboarders from the Z Boys, the Zephyr Crew down in Dogtown, Stacy Peralta, Nathan Pratt. Alrighty, guys, so I hope you thoroughly enjoyed this little ride along through Mar Vista Knoll, bringing to you exactly what this neighborhood has to offer, giving you a little inside scoop as to what Mar Vista is all about. If you're thinking about moving here, maybe the video turns you on, you're like, gosh, I gotta get out there. Or if you're local already thinking about moving to Mar Vista or selling for that matter, more than happy to help you out. Even if you just have some questions, all my contact information is right below in the description, as well as all my social media platforms, so we can stay in touch and you can get updates and other really cool tips, tricks, and strategies that are working in this market and any market for that matter to be successful. So have an awesome weekend. Enjoy it, stay safe, and I'll see you next week.